Maybe it's just me. The man that got away. It's karaoke night, and I'm out with George and Slutty Mandy, listening to a man put the finishing touches on destroying Blondie's heart of glass. As we watch with unmasked horror, I picture Debbie Harry busting in and kicking his ass. You know she totally could. If you're a karaoke enthusiast, the three of us are the bar patrons you hate most. We are not here to sing. We are here to openly judge others. If I could convince George to say dog a lot, we'd be just like the panel on American Idol. We dodge the inevitable requests for us to take the stage by having very stringent guidelines. Slutty Mandy will not sing unless the catalog includes a Smith song other than How Soon Is Now. I will only perform songs covered by Dave Matthews or Elaine Stritch, and George's repertoire is limited to an impersonation of late-career Judy Garland drunkenly warbling The Man That Got Away. It goes without saying that this elaborate setup is merely covering for the fact that we're all too chicken shit to actually sing. My two friends have brought me out to speed the recovery process after my latest object of interest, the erstwhile carman, either dropped me or was kidnapped. Whatever it was, he hasn't called in 2 weeks, which I've been instructed to take as a sign he's not going to do so. I'm bummed about it primarily because Carmen seemed to be a fairly normal guy, which is a rarity for me. I tend to have the same effect on crazy people as Josh Groban does on middle-aged housewives.
You know, darling, when a guy doesn't call me back, I always...
Always what?
I'm trying to remember a time when that's happened.
Mandy?
Don't look at me. This is why I don't give out my number.
Sometimes it's best for friends to offer silent support. A handsome young man takes to the stage with a winning smile and easy confidence.
Musical theater major.
A few bars of Can You Feel the Love Tonight proves their assessment devastatingly accurate.
I'm going to Los Angeles next week.
What for?
Getting laid.
3,000 miles for a booty call? Why?
Why do men climb Everest, Topher? Because it's there.
Well, you can't really argue with the logic. I'm all the more intrigued because Los Angeles happens to be the current home of the man who could call me at any given moment, tell me to drop everything and come to him, and I would. I think everybody's got one. The unattainable ideal, the person with whom life would be perfect if only they felt the same. But you know they never will. At least your brain knows that. Your heart foolishly refuses to catch up. I share these thoughts with the group.
I absolutely have one of those. I dated him years ago, back in college. We hardly ever talk. But I do wonder if he said, let's try it again.
Mine's a writer, with a very tenuous grasp of reality. Just like me.
That sounds perfect.
You two are pitiful and need to get laid.
Oh, come on, Mandy. You're telling me you never get dewy-eyed thinking about one that got away?
Of course I don't. But I'm sure I'm that person for someone else. Most likely several people.
Slutty Mandy has the strength of conviction on this subject that people only achieve when they are completely full of shit. But she does bring up an alternative viewpoint I hadn't considered. If I'm sitting in this bar thinking about some fella who stole my heart and never knew, it's entirely possible that somewhere out there someone's thinking the same thing about me. The trick is finding him and seeing if he's a crazy person.